Hi, today we're going to learn how to improve the speed of a slow-moving website. We're going to be using the developers.google.com/speed/paid speed/insights tool, or you can just Google page speed insights and it'll take you to that tool. You can see that this is a very low score for the website they're going to be working on. And I'm primarily recording this video for myself so that I can remember how to do this, because I thought I'd remember all these steps when I went to do it again and I forgot. So when you use this tool, it teaches you all the, well, it doesn't teach you, it shows you all the things that you need to fix, and it will give you details on how to fix them or what's going wrong. Essentially, it's telling me I need to optimize my images, eliminate render blocking JavaScript and CSS and above the fold content, reduce server response time, leverage browser caching. And if I click, it will show me suggestions on how to fix these things, but that doesn't always make sense to a non-techie person like myself. But there's a lot of fun in learning, so I went ahead and figured out how to do it. I'm going to focus on this step on this video, eliminating render blocking JavaScript and CSS and above the fold content. And essentially, I was able to fix a lot of the problem by installing this plugin, Auto Optimize, without the extra O in there. And it does a lot of the work for us by concatenating the CSS and JavaScript code and compressing it. And if you're not understanding anything that I'm saying right now, welcome to the club. You don't have to understand this. I do think you can follow these steps though and figure this out. So first of all, go install the plugin, and then you're going to want to activate it. But I want to show you some things before you do that. So this is exactly what the source code looks like on this website before this auto-optimized is activated. You can see that there are a lot of spaces in here, and it's going to remove all of the spaces that aren't required when I load that. And how you view your page source, by the way, is you just go to your website and then right-click, go to View Page Source, and bingo, there you go. That's how you see it. So anyway, that's how I got there. So that is what we see. So we're going to activate this plugin. I'll show you what it does. Once it's activated, I'm going to be able to refresh. Oops, not that one. Sorry, wrong page. Refresh. And you can see a lot of the spaces have been taken out. But that does not fix the problem. If you go back and run a speed test, you'll see that this is all still here, and all these problems are all still here. By the way, I fixed a lot of this. There were a ton of these problems in here, but a lot of this got fixed individually when I entered in the auto-optimize plugin, and I ran this test, and then it fixed a lot of them, but it was still giving me these other problems, so that's why the score is still so low. But there were a whole list of things in here. So anyway, but it will still give you this problem, and I want to thank my unknown friends at wpfaster.org. They also have a video on how to eliminate render blocking CSS and above the fold content, which was very helpful to me, but it didn't actually fix all the problems for my site, which is why I'm recording my own video. So I will learn this, I will remember the steps. Anyway, one of the things that you have to do is you have to use this critical path CSS generator, and you can access it at that URL that you see above. So copy down that URL that you see. This is what you have to use and able to find the critical path. And this is how we do this. We go to our source, and you can see right after style sheet at the very top, you see this file, HTTP, master disaster, all the things that are just here behind the style sheet. Grab that, copy it, click it, and copy all of it. Every single last bit of it. Move it into this box. Oops, I have some other stuff in here. Let me clear that out. Move it into this box. And then make sure that the web page that you want to create the critical CSS for is listed up here, and then hit Create Clinical Path Generator. And once that's done, this is all that's needed to fix the problem that we had eliminating render blocking JavaScript and CSS code. This is going to help a great deal. So we grab and copy all of this, and we take it to our plugin. So go in and click Settings. And when you first open this up, by the way, I have Advanced open, you will open this up and it will look like this. You're going to want to click all of the boxes and ignore the bottom. And we're working in Advanced Settings. So we're going to be clicking on Inline and Defer CSS, which will pop open a box that I pasted all of this information into. And another thing, and then you would want to save that, but another thing is that you want to make sure that all of the exclude scripts from auto-optimize, it somehow automatically inserts things in here. Take all that out. Take out the exclude the CSS, because it will automatically pop in some code in there. Take that out. And then you also need to click just about as many boxes as you can. So you're also going to aggregate inline JS. I have found that I get a higher score when I remove Google Fonts, and that, you know, you might have to do some changes in CSS to make your website look pretty again, but for some reason, sometimes that will slow up a website considerably. Generate URIs for images. Also aggregate inline CSS. And that's everything. This was automatically already clicked. And then I hit Save Changes and Empty Cache. And now we have fixed something. Let's just take a look and see what we've done. Much higher score. You can see that there is still a code that's in here that they want me to fix, but it has taken away a lot of the other things that were in there in my original list. Sorry, I don't have a screenshot of that. And so that has considerably reduced the problem and increased the score. So that is all for this video. Thank you for watching.